Let's plot the degree distribution for this graph. We'll need to do this again soon, so we can put all of this together as a function. I'm going to call this function plot degree distribution. And it takes in my graph g. This is my function definition. Then I'd like to look at the degrees. So we have the g.degree, which returns to us a dictionary. I'm interested in the values, which are the degrees of the different nodes. I first want to turn that into a list. I turn this into a list because g.degree.values gives me a view object to the values. I actually want to create a copy of that and turn it into a list. That's why I include the list surrounding the g.degree values object. We can then use the plt_hist function to draw this. And my histogram type, histtype, is going to be step. We could use almost anything, but this just works well for this specific purpose. And then we want to add our x labels. So plt.xlabel is going to be degree k. If you're familiar with LaTeX, you know that we can put dollar signs around the k, and the k will get rendered as a LaTeX k letter. We can also add a y label. And that's just going to be p of k, the probability of observing a node with that degree. Finally, we can add a title using plt.title. I'm going to call this degree distribution. That's our function definition. Let's run that. And we can now generate a new graph. Let's say g is equal to er graph. Let's go with 50 nodes and a probability 0.08. That's my g. And then I can plot that degree distribution. I'm just going to copy it from here. And I'm going to save that to a file. I'll turn it into a PDF file. I'll call this hist1.pdf. Then we can look for hist1. And this is our degree histogram. Looking at the histogram, we'll see that there are some nodes that have 0 degree, so they have no connections. And the most connected node has 10 connections. A majority of the nodes appear to have somewhere between perhaps 4 and 7 edges, although the result is not that clear. The reason for that is that our graph is relatively small. We can create a clearer plot or a cleaner plot by increasing the number of nodes in our graph. Let's go with 500 in this case. We've run the same code again. Let's then look for the plot on the computer, hist1. And in this case, we'll see that the histogram looks different. So we have a larger graph in this case. So most of the nodes have higher degree than before. That's because previously, each node had 50-1, or 49 potential nodes that they could connect to. In this case, we have 500 nodes. So any node can connect to any of the remaining 500-1 nodes. So in this case, we would expect the degree, the average degree, to be higher than previously. If we look at the histogram again, we'll see that there are no nodes that have fewer than 25 connections. And also, there are no nodes that have more than 63 or 64 connections. The majority of the nodes appear to have somewhere between perhaps 35 and 50 connections. Let's next try generating a couple of different graphs using our ergraph function, and then we can plot the degree distributions for all of those graphs. I'm going to call this g1. I'll plot the degree distribution for g1. I can do this again for g2 and plot the degree distribution for g2. We can do this one more time. We generate graph g3, and then we plot its degree distribution. I'm going to call this hist3. We can then find his 3 on the computer. In this case, we have 3 plots, 3 histograms, because we have 3 different graphs. Because every graph realization will be different from any other, that means that the specific degree distribution of any graph is going to be somewhat different from that of any other graph. In this case, we can see that the 3 degree distributions follow one another fairly closely. This is an example of degree distributions drawn from 3 different Eta Cyrenaic graphs.